Today I'm showing you this new Saab 9.3 throttle hose, which I have been involved in the development of with the factory that makes it. So let me show you how to change it and tell you a little bit about the development. The stock Saab 9.3 throttle body hose is of course made of rubber, which is fine. Rubber's a great product for these hoses, but it does age, and when it ages it can go hard and brittle, which means you can get splits in the hoses. And also, when it starts to go hard and brittle, it starts to lose its grip on the pipes that it's attached to. And that's exactly the problem I've been having with mine. This hose has popped off the throttle body two or three times under high boost now, so time to replace. You can actually buy replacement hoses for this fitment from a number of places, especially on sites like eBay, and that's exactly what I did, and here it is. But it wasn't until after I got the hose that I realised that this one didn't fit properly. So I did some more research and also had a look at a lot more reviews from a wide range of sellers, and found that other people had had this problem too, and that there were in fact some feedback points about it. The main problem with it was that this angle here and this length are wrong. You have to bend this over in order to get it on the outlet from the intercooler, and when you do, it squashes in that corner and causes a restriction in airflow. I actually found that I could feel the restriction. She felt restricted. So I got in touch with the same people who make my one-piece top radiator hose that deletes the plastic T here. So I provided them with a couple of samples of stock hoses, and they modelled up some new tooling, and this is actually the first part of the new tooling. I did a test fit. There was a very minor discrepancy with the length just here. I had to get them to make it just 5 millimetres longer, which they have done. But other than that, it's an absolutely perfect fit. Let me show you. It's really easy to fit a new hose. To get the hose off, undo these two hose clips at each end, at the throttle body and the pipe from the intercooler, either with a large flat screwdriver or a 7 millimetre socket. Pull the hose off from each end. Recover the hose clips, you'll need those. On the new hose, just put a very tiny smear of silicone grease just around the inside of both ends. That will help it to slide on. The hose clip is hanging on the hard pipe here, but don't forget to slip this hose clip on and just push it back on. And as you can see, that goes on perfect. Just a matter of re-tightening the clips now. When you're tightening up the clip round the throttle body end, just nip the clip up. I have done a short video on this, but don't over tighten it. Just enough to squeeze the silicone tube just underneath the neck on the throttle body inlet. If you over tighten it, you run the risk of distorting the throttle body inlet. The hose itself actually has a slightly better controlled radius around here than the stock hose does, and it is about 2 millimetres bigger in the internal diameter. It probably has an improved flow compared to the stock hose. I mean, it should do anyway, because the hose is fitted with a liner on top of which is a 4-ply silicone, burst pressure around 240 psi. The big thing is that it's a perfect fit. You could also use this if you're doing a modified inlet with a big intercooler and aluminium pipes coming up here. I'll put a link in the description to where you can buy this from. It's a link to an AliExpress listing which takes advantage of subsidised postage and the protections that you get buying off AliExpress, which are similar protections to buyer protection in PayPal. In fact, you can use PayPal on AliExpress. And all of that enables us to keep the price down. The price will vary ever so slightly from country to country, depending on the exchange rates, but it should be around about £40. They're also available in all the same colours as the top radiator hose, including black if you prefer the original equipment look. And of course, if you do buy one, you'll be supporting the channel. So if you do, thank you in advance. If you got value for this video, please be sure to hit the like button, and I shall see you next time.